Hello and welcome to the Slingshot channel. Today we are gonna dig a 2,500 years old weapon out of its grave and try to enhance it in a way that would have thought unbelievable beforehand. I'm talking about the gastraphides, an ancient Greek weapon that actually has been reproduced by my colleague and friend Todd from Todd's Workshop. He actually did a video about it a few years ago, and he made a beautiful replica. I think you can even order one from him, and he will actually make it for you upon your specifications, and it costs around 1,200 British pounds, which I think for a handmade piece is a major steal. The gastraphides was basically a very simple crossbow, but made special by one feature. You don't need muscle power to cock it. You do this with your body weight. So it's also called a belly bow, since you know you just hold it like a bicycle handle or something, and then you lean on it, and with your body weight you're actually pressing down on this thing, cocking it. I think ingenious, specifically for people who prefer to eat rather than going to the gym. This episode was so much fun. And of course, I had to buy a ton of things that I could only afford because not only I have support from you, my loyal fans, but also from my loyal sponsors. And therefore, this is another episode that is sponsored by the greatest game in the world, Raid Shadow Legends. I just love that game because first, it is available on all devices, desktops, cell phones, no matter what type. It just is everywhere. Second, it is full with great champions, more than 500 champions, and they have some seriously evil bosses. Huge beasts that you get to fight. And the combinations of the champions and of the weapons and skills in the way how you fight makes it really, really, really flexible. But it is still super easy to play. In fact, they even have an autoplay mode that I love. Actually, when I did the research for this video, I let the game run all the time. And whenever I needed a break, I just stopped and watched a little bit of it and played a little bit with it. A game that lets you design deadly weapons while you play it? What's not to love about that? The Raid guys asked me to name my two favorite champions for this episode. And that's an easy decision. First of all, I name Ethel, a tall, tall, blonde warrior woman that I actually got to meet in person while visiting Raid in Ukraine. I'm not sure how they found this woman, but she looked just like the real thing and she was huge, but very beautiful. And the other champion that I picked is Coldheart. Well, because as you see, it's winter time in Germany and it's about archery. And here is an archery champion that also is beautiful and loves the gold. Every time I think they're running out of ideas, they come up with something sensationally new, like the Tower of Doom. It's a huge tower. It's like, it just gives you so many new ways to experience this game. And even there is a new champion that is just perfect for storming that tower. It's called Bulwark. I love Bulwark. And you can get Bulwark as a champion. Because if you download the game from my link below, within the next 30 days from the upload day of this video, you will get a lot of free things. You will get Bulwark, of course, but you will also get an XP booster, 50 gems, some energy refills, and an ancient shard. I think Bulwark alone is worth downloading the game. And once you're installed it, you will find your rewards in the inbox. Okay, now back to the task at hand. Improving the 2,500-year-old gastraphides concept. Now first, I encourage you to watch Todd's video about this. Actually, I put the link down below so you can watch it. I'm taking a few screenshots and I hope that he won't be angry with me because of that. But because if you look at the weapon, it had the serious advantage to be easy to cock. But what can we enhance? What is necessary to enhance? Well, first of all, the reloading time. I actually measured this and I found that Todd, who was really doing a good job loading it quickly, took about 30 seconds to make it ready for another shot. So 30 seconds is a long time. It's not that slow, but it still is a long time, I believe. Second, it's kind of awkward to shoot, and Todd even says this in his video. Because what you have to do is you actually have to hold it like here, like this, and then you will have to press it against your belly, since you need the other hand to release the trigger. Now, it's very hard to aim, and also Todd admits that that is the case. So that's a serious disadvantage. There are some more disadvantages. Todd actually says that it is clumsy to load, because as soon as the bow is getting too heavy, it is really clumsy, and it will also be very heavy at the at the head part. So it gets harder to hold the more heavy the bow is. So it's another very clear disadvantage. And to me, the biggest disadvantage is how bulky it is. Not only is it really wide because it's using a very big recurve bow, but also it is very deep because you have this spade-like shaft and handle that allows you to press down on it. So these are serious disadvantages that we need to overcome. This is my most clumsy instant Legolas that I've ever made. As you see, it's powered by an English longbow, which has about the same length as the bows that were used for the Gastrophides. And it's also the reason why I'm looking at the weapon. So many fans said, what you have reminds us so much on the Gastrophides, why don't you turn it into one? Because it also has a sliding part. As you see, it has a magazine with the four arrows in here. And of course, you know, it's not supposed to be drawn back by hand, but there's nothing that prevents you from putting it down on the ground and then pushing on it to load it. Except that, of course, your arms are not long enough. So you would put it down and try to cock it, but you see at the end of my arm, where this thing is touching my chest, I am running out of space. And also, of course, it needs to lock at the end, which this one doesn't do, since otherwise how can I pick it up from the ground and shoot it safely? So I need to also convert this into a crossbow. So in order to overcome the first problem, the clumsy size, it is of course very simple. We just move to a modern bow, like a compound bow. This is not my invention, actually it was invented a year after I was born, in 1966. And ever since that, of course, it had huge success. Now most modern bows are compound bows, means that they have eccentric discs here, basically allowing for shorter and harder limbs, and also giving you a let-off so that in the fully cocked condition they have less draw resistance. See, this of course is a very powerful bow, goes up to 70 pounds and gives you more performance than an English longbow at the same draw weight, but it is a lot smaller. And I also attached an instant Legolas, a commercially available version called the Fenris, made by Steamboat in Austria. And this of course is still a bow, so this means that I can hold it like this. Still a bow, because I'm only holding it back here with my index finger, like so. And I can shoot it very hard and very powerful. And of course I could also convert this into a Gastrophides with some additional work. But this bow actually is lightweight, and I have no need to turn it into a Gastrophides because I can easily draw it out with my arms. So I would have to find a more powerful compound bow, which is tough because the hardest ones on the market go up to maybe 80 pounds, and this is 70 pounds, so it's not much difference. I would have to use one that is like twice as heavy, twice as hard to cock as this one. But there's none on the market, so we have to be creative. My idea is to simply use two of these and mount it next to each other, and that of course will only be possible if the other bow is one that is made for left-handers, so that it would be mirrored, so it would have an opening here, so that the magazine can fit between the two bows. And of course I also have to combine the two bowstrings accordingly. Three major technical challenges in this build. First, take two compound bows and mount them sideways so that they are attached to each other with enough room for a magazine to fit through. Second big thing, convert it into a crossbow so that at the end of the draw it will actually lock. Third part, attach handles that are not too clumsy, but that allow me to use my body weight to cock the whole contraption, because it is physically impossible to draw two bows of 70 pounds each out just with the hand if you are not a superhuman. Can we do it? Sure. Let me show you what I came up with. Meet the 21st century repeating double compound Gastrophetus. Let me show you its features. All right, so as you see, it's in fact really two bows. And as you can see, it's the grayback bow, which I really love, specifically because it's also available in a left-handed version. So I have two of them mounted to each other. And in the middle, I installed a very early prototype of the Fenris that was still from the development phase, and I had it here and it was no longer in use. So I used for this project, and you can see it's not even anodized, therefore it's just naked aluminum. But it is certainly good enough for the project. I installed two handles, and as you see, those are short, much shorter than the handles that you find in the original Gastrophetus, because I found it really is not necessary to really make it extending so long. All you need, of course, is you need a little room between your outstretched arms and your chest, and that can still poke out like this. So that was really not a problem at all to just leave it that way. So this is not adding a lot of length to the bow itself. Also, I installed a red dot. Actually, Todd said that it's hard to aim with this thing. No wonder, you have to shoot it pressed against your belly, so you have no sighting system. Not necessary with this weapon here. Both bows are set to the maximum power, 70 pounds each. So this now has 140 pounds of a draw. And it is absolutely physically impossible now to draw this out with your hands. Oh, you can forget about it. Specifically since you will actually cant it a little bit, since you're only holding it on the left side, and the canting adds additional friction. So it's absolutely impossible to shoot this like a normal bow. It is now a crossbow. And because it's a crossbow, it also has a locking device in the front, consisting of this little thing mounted to the muzzle here, and also consisting of this little spring-loaded handle and lock that is attached to the bow frame. One more issue that I had to solve is how to make one bowstring out of two in a way that the cams would not be derailed. Because they, of course, need to have the same distance. So I installed these little spacers here, made from wood. And as you see, they're spacing it. And only down here, and of course on the other side, the string is tied into one. And then there's a middle serving that actually ties them firmly in the middle. So this means that when I draw the bow out, the cams will still stay perfectly aligned. And so there's nothing is going to be derailed. So enough talking. Let's now get it ready to shoot. So first what you do is you slide it to the front until the trigger grabs the string. Now you put it down like so. And now you see I have these two handles here, and those handles are mounted in a way that the sled is actually centered in between this. It's very important because this way I don't cant the bow while cocking it, making friction not an issue. Okay, now I lean down on it. And as you see, it is of course a little bit hard, but actually, all in all, it's super simple. And it's all done with my body weight, and fortunately, I have enough of that. Specifically after Christmas. And now I can pick up the bow and shoot it just as normal. It's not even so heavy, it's about 6 kilos, fully loaded. Okay, let's shoot. Very short distance, but it doesn't matter. And fire! Whoa! I think it really jammed the whole thing deep into the archery mat. Wow. And now if I want to shoot again, it's very simple. Just slide it back to the front, put it down, lean on it, get the weapon back up, and shoot. As you see, it's very quick. I think it's the quickest way to cock a powerful crossbow. Look at this, folks, how far they're poking out of the triple layer archery mat. Whoa. So now, in order to find out if it's really a difference if I use two bows at the same time or just a single bow, I have this version, which is exactly the same bow, exactly at the same setting. Everything is the same, it's just a single bow. It actually is a relief because it's so much lighter. And of course, it's also quicker to shoot. But will it have the same power? Well, let's shoot it into the same archery mat and find out. On this here, I have the laser attached, which I could also, of course, attach to the double version, to the Gastrofides version, but I ran out of lasers. Okay, let's go for it. I'm gonna aim a little bit to the right so that you can see the difference, and I'm holding under a little bit too. Okay, let's compare. So the difference is very obvious. Those two shots are actually poking out like a good 20 centimeters each, and those were from the double version. Whereas the first version here actually is poking out to the other side. And if we pull this out, it's getting hard. You can see that the penetration was just about to the end of the archery mat. So absolutely, clearly there is a difference. The double bow has more performance, but if you really want to know how much better it performs, we have to crony the results. Okay, so we have the FX Radar Crony, and we are shooting at like a 10 meter distance, but of course the Crony is right here. Now the way the Radar Crony works is, even if I shoot it at point blank, it doesn't matter, because it actually only will grab the projectile about 2 meters in direction of the target, because it's working on a radar and not on a light base. So you can actually use this one in darkness. In any case, the original bolts that I'm using first are 23 grams in weight, and I'll be shooting two of them, and I'm hoping that the Radar Crony will pick up the results. So first, the single bow. Okay. meters per second. Let's go again. 82 meters per second. That is not bad. Actually, it's a really nice bow, specifically for the money. Now let's see. 96 meters per second. Definitely faster. Let's do one more. 96 again. I'm happy that I have this history here so I can check it out. So of course that is not quite as much as twice the energy, although it is significantly more. But it's also of course clear that with a poundage that high, you're not supposed to shoot the same lightweight arrow. It actually might even damage the bow, and it's a sign for the good quality of the Greyback bow that it did not take any harm. But we have to use a heavier arrow to really test it. So I made this one. Actually, you may think it's completely the same, but it is not, because I put in a length of a steel nail and a wooden stick as a spacer. And of course it still is front heavy, so it will fly stable, but this now weighs 55 grams instead of 23 grams. So it actually is more than twice as heavy, and that should get the maximum energy out of the new bow. Now it's cocked and locked and ready for the 55 gram arrow. Let's hope that I'm going to hit the target. And fire! Whoa, 71 meters per second, and I think it flew straight through the target and crashed into the wall behind. So the normal one came out at 77 joule, which is already quite impressive for a compound bow that is still so lightweight and manageable. But the double compound Gastrofides actually came to a whopping 138 joule. So it is not quite as powerful as twice the original one, because 77 times 2 is definitely more than 138. But you can see that my prediction was about correct. It's not reaching twice the amount, but it is coming very close to that. And this is what it means in real life. These are the two shots with the normal 70 pound single bow. Those are the two shots from the double bow, but with the light arrow. And that that is the arrow from the third shot, and still it's not really sticking in very hard, but it definitely penetrated the entire archery mat all the way. So the double compound repeating 21st century gastrophilus. Is it a success? I think so. I think I mastered the challenge. I've made a weapon that you cannot cock by hand anymore. So it's like as heavy to draw like a crossbow, but it has the draw length of a bow. And it is actually really combining two compound bows in a way that there is plenty of efficiency. It is still fairly compact, although it is also pretty heavy. But I think it solves most of the issues that actually Todd had with the original one. Hard to aim, clumsy to operate, slow to reload, not too strong. I think this is all solved by this thing here. So I'm actually happy with it, I think, and it was so much fun. All the problem solving was so much fun. So will this be a commercial product? No, certainly not, because it just makes no sense. It is still too bulky and so on, but, you know, I always said I don't want to make an instant Legolas version out of a modern, very powerful crossbow, like a Revan or something, maybe even with a reverse draw. The thing is that I said that because I said these things take too much time to reload, you know, until you have engaged the winch and everything and finished with all these preparations or use the help string, you know. This makes no sense. You lose so much time cocking the thing that it really doesn't help if it saves you some time putting in another arrow. But with this here, this changes, because now it's completely effortless to cock the bow. And then it may, in fact, make sense to have a magazine attached to one of these powerful crossbows. Since this definitely only requires that you're eating well, not that you're working out. Now, will it replace the normal Fenris or Instant Legolas? No, because this is such an elegant, lightweight weapon. And it's so quick shooting, because definitely faster to shoot than something that you have to put down to the ground. Power is also really sufficient, 77 joule. Actually, this would be legal with this kind of power, maybe not with the contraption, but with the power and energy of the shot, it would be legal to hunt big game in the US. So I think this is pretty powerful, and there's really no need to go up as high. But of course, there's no thing like too much power. Would you not agree? Still, I love the thing because it's so much fun to shoot and so easy, and you can keep it directed to the target while you reload. So much fun. And quick. And this one here, well, this is a weapon to beat an end boss in raid. That's why I think it's such a great match to the game that sponsors this video, that made it possible to buy all these wonderful bows to be employed here. So I'm very happy about this. And I ask you and encourage you, and actually I would love to see you using the link down below and downloading Raid. And if you already have it, then go and play with it. It's so much fun. I'll definitely do the same as soon as I have some more free time. Anyway, I hope you like this, because that's it for today. Thanks and bye. Bye. Whoa. Okay, one for you, as always.